How to Succeed in Business is a parody of the emergence of giant corporate America. It makes fun of the possibility that somebody with virtually no ability can rise to the top of one of the largest corporations in America, and that's sort of the thrill of the show. It has the sense of being a little bit make-believe. The characters don't have real names. They have names like Mr. Bigley and Bud Frump. And to me, that's kind of a clue. They don't make anything that's useful, as far as we know. They make wickets. They're the worldwide wicket company. So the challenge is, it has to feel like a giant, giant corporation. The corporation is so big, they keep saying that nobody knows what anybody else does there. And that's kind of crucial to the story.
We're in the brotherhood of man.
I was interested in trying to find a way that both created that sense of hugeness and anonymity, but also playfulness.
In that fraternity,
the great big brotherhood of men.
I was really interested in the architecture of Saarinen. This stuff used a lot of kind of organic forms and softer shapes. From that, I was sort of drawn to the notion of a beehive, of a honeycomb, as a kind of metaphor for the busyness that is the worldwide wicket company. We're doing this production in the sort of context of Mad Men, which has a very, very strong visual iconography. The thing about Mad Men is visually really, really chic and really quite dark. I was interested in trying to make this feel a little less chic and a little more playful. A little bit more like a kind of happy place. Creating this kind of structure with the honeycomb that kind of moved in an interesting way was something we worked very, very hard on.
It's basically a false floor. It's about 8 inches thick and was put down for this show. And it contains lighting, as you can see, and it contains automation track. So this automation track here is used for the elevator, which comes down a couple of times. And the elevator has a turtle in it, which makes it able to rotate, because we have to be able to see outside the elevator and inside the elevator.
And these structures sort of reconfigure continuously throughout the show. These big towers move on and off. There's sliders that come in and out. You have to create some transitions that are fun to watch, that are interesting to watch, but that are not exhausting. And it's possible to have scenery that moves in a way that will actually sort of tire the audience. It needs to feel like it's part of the choreography. It has a certain meter to it, and it can't go faster or slower than that.
That's the boardroom table there. I showed a nice little detail on it, which only people in the mezzanine can see. People in the orchestra never get to see this. We did like a version of the inlay logo on the boardroom table. We try to watch out for the people upstairs.